After being ignored initially, Bengaluru, along with six other state capitals, have finally made it into the race for the 100 smart cities. There is much to cheer, but will the 500 crores be enough to make Bengaluru a smart city? And what are Bengalurians expecting in their smart city? Stacey Pereira finds out.
Like better connectivity with the police, any sort of officials or the government. So if I have any sort of problem, I should be able to connect with them and get an immediate response.
Free Wi-Fi to start with. Free Wi-Fi everywhere would be great.
The metro should be spread out around the city more.
I think the government schools should become a little more high-tech, and for students they should have smart classes.
This endless citizens wish list has a fair chance of being fulfilled. Bengaluru is readying itself to submit a detailed plan for developments of its urban clusters for the next round of the smart city competition.
Bengaluru is already a smart city, the one of the IT hub, nothing. Everybody's talk is after Silicon City of US. This is the Silicon City of India. We already are entrusting this work to a consultant. As per their advice, whatever the things we ought to fulfill, we definitely will do it. We welcome this move of including Bengaluru into the smart city.
So how will this change things on ground? A recently launched intelligent transport system hopes to help commuters in BMTC buses keep track of the vehicle and also know how long the bus will take to come at the said bus stop. The extension of phase 1 of the Namma Metro, this time going underground, has brought much relief to Bengaluru's congested roads. A nod from the BDA to start work on the peripheral ring road will also help ease traffic. And with the newly formed Bangalore Blueprint Action Group, application of smart solutions for sustainable and inclusive developments will hopefully take Bengaluru closer to the finishing line in this smart city race.
The group, if you look at it, like, you know, they're well-known names. Like, you know, these are Bangalurians, and they would definitely know. They've helped grow Bangalore. They're the best, like, you know, who can advise in terms of what are the pain points, like, and what initiatives should be taken, right? But the thing is, once these guys, like, you know, give the pointers, I think that has to be very efficiently implemented and completed.
Many, however, would argue that Bengaluru is already a smart city and that the current state budget provides for over 500 crores for the city's development. This still hasn't made much of a difference as the city continues to grapple with many issues, especially that of an inefficient governing system.
We don't have good governance, you don't have competent people, you don't have city managers who are sophisticated, who are forward-looking, things are going to fall apart. And that's exactly what is going to happen. And for all I know, smart city may collapse and we will not see results unless the government of India insists the governance mechanism is...
The city's administrators have their tasks cut out. Corporate India, as well as civic-minded citizens, will have to work together to help Bengaluru emerge as the winning smart city. In Bengaluru, with camera persons Nasir and Alphonse, Stacey Pereira for NDTV.